Hi, I'm Michelle Donegan. I'm at Telecoms Europe Live, and I'm here with Patrick Rokita, who is Chief Technology Officer at Titanium Platform. Hello, Patrick. Thanks for joining us today, Michelle.
Thank you for the interaction.
Now, first of all, congratulations, because you've just taken on the role of CTO at Titanium Platform. Can you tell us a bit about the company and its role in the telco industry?
Thank you, Michelle, for the introduction. And now, who is Titanium Platform? So Titanium Platform is a spin-off of its parent company called NetNumber that was founded back in 1999. We are located in the Greater Boston area, Massachusetts, and are specialized in providing core network applications with a focus on signaling, routing, security, subscriber data management. We do that since 25 years. We are deployed in more than 200 customers around the globe. And the examples of our deployments include ENAM and DNS for service discovery and number portability, signaling firewalls for network security, SDP and diameter signaling controller for advanced routing and interconnect, HLR, HSS for subscriber data management, steer-shaken for the protection of caller ID, and just recently also selected 5G core network components, providing for network function profile repository, network slicing, session binding, secure communication proxy, and security edge protection proxy. To address the unique needs of our clients, we are delivering customer-defined applications. And last but not least, we are proactive in GSMA, chairing the Diameter End-to-End Signaling Security Group and the 5G Mobile Roaming Revisited Group. So that's what Titanium Platform is about.
So as CTO, you see a lot of technology trends coming. Which are the ones that are keeping you up at night, and how are they going to affect the telco industry?
We are currently at the peak of 5G, at least from the user equipment and radio access network perspective. So in my opinion, it's time to think about the next G. And here, the enterprises and verticals, non-terrestrial networks, extended reality, and artificial intelligence is in the focus of the industry. And each of these focus areas has its associated technologies that will enable them. So in case of enterprises and verticals, they will need network slicing. Yeah. Non-terrestrial networks will need quantum computing and a high degree of autonomy. The extended reality will need spectrum and technologies providing for high symmetrical bit rates and low latency. And artificial intelligence will need exposure of the network and services via APIs. It will also need quantum computing, and for testing and machine learning, it will need digital twins. So as a result, the network will move closer to the devices, and the services will move closer to the mobile edge. And what is currently driving me around is, you know, what will there be left up for the mobile core, where actually Titanium Platform is addressing its niche knowledge. And here we are able to address both existing and future requirements of the industry. So we are ready for next G. And in addition, we are exposing our assets that we have in the network and platform area to operators, development teams, so that they can make the best out of their networks and monetize the services they build.
Telecom operators are sunsetting their 2G and 3G networks, but there's still a lot of traffic on those networks. What are some of the challenges that operators are facing as they go through this evolution?
Excellent question. So the abolition of the 3G network has already happened in many countries around the globe, while the sunset of the 2G networks is continuing for the next at least 5 years. And the biggest challenge, in my opinion, is the replacement of devices that utilize 2G services, and also the support of outbound roamers in countries where there is as yet no full 4G, 5G coverage. And for the duration of this transition that is happening globally, there will still be a need to maintain a 2G network footprint in the operator's home network. And the big question is whether this 2G service footprint will be kept unchanged till the majority of the 2G services will be switched off around the globe, or whether these 2G services will be migrated to cloud native. So that's the big question, and we at Titanium Platform, we have already successfully migrated selected as a 7 services to cloud native. So we are ready for that. We can help our operators to utilize cloud native infrastructures of their choice for both legacy and 5G, and also the processes that are defined along with the microservices architectures and containers like CI/CD, continuous deployment, and canary roles, and so on.
Okay, so at this event, you are participating in a panel called If Network Slicing is the Answer, What is the Question? So what is your view on the importance of network slicing?
To me, network slicing is a technology that delivers secure networks to verticals requiring dedicated quality of service characteristics or a secure isolated environment. And network slicing is further a viable technology for the implementation of artificial intelligence and associated machine learning. But in the end, it will be up to the operators to come up with services they can monetize. Yeah. In my eyes, the monetization of services is a key in a world that requires large investment into complex networks, delivering a high degree of service availability, resiliency, and security. And therefore, you know, the revenues must be fairly split between the service providers, network providers, and the vendors. To me, network slicing is an ongoing journey for the at least last 3 years that will continue. And for us at Titanium Platform, we have the 5G core network components involved in network slicing already available to our clients. So we are ready.
Patrick, thanks very much for your time.
My pleasure.